The Israelites have crossed the Jordan River into the land of Canaan, and God has given them the city of Jericho. The walls have fallen down flat. But God also gave them some instructions. He said, "Now listen, when you go into the city of Jericho, I won this battle, you didn't, so don't take anything out. Everything in Jericho is to be burned up, except for the gold and the silver, and all of that belongs to me, because I won the battle." So that was God's instruction. Well, they went into the city and they burned everything up. And by the way, they found that burned city. They found food that's been burned to a crisp, buried in the ground. They found the walls that have fallen down. And there was one fellow whose name was Achan. And Achan went into Jericho, and he was doing what God told him to do. And as he walked along, he stumbled on something that was on the floor, on the ground. And he looked down, and he picked up a piece of cloth and sort of shook the dust off of it, and it was a lovely purple robe, a Babylonian robe, it looked like, with gold down the front of it. And he thought, that looks like it would just fit me. It's a shame to burn up this beautiful robe. And he rolled it up very quickly, and he looked this way and this way, and nobody was looking. But Achan was mistaken, and he stuffed the robe inside his coat. Now he's walking along a little further, and he sees some sunlight just bouncing off of something in the road. And he went up and went, blew the dust off of it, and it was a gold brick. And he thought, boy, I could have a new tent. I could get some clothes, some material for my wife to make clothes. I could buy a couple of new sheep. There's no need to just burn this up or even give it away. And he looked around and nobody was looking. But Achan was mistaken. And he stuck that gold wedge inside the other side of his coat. Now he's beginning to look a little bulky. And so as he's going along, he's headed home toward his tent to put this stuff up. And as he's headed home, he hears something jingling in the dirt as he's walking, and he looks down, and there's a bunch of silver. And he picks up all the shekels of silver, sticks them in his pocket, and heads home, and nobody has seen him. But Achan was mistaken, because he forgot to look up. And when he got back to his tent, he went way back into the back of the tent, and he dug a hole, and he took out the purple robe and put that in the hole, and he put the gold wedge in, and he thought about all the exciting things he could buy with the gold wedge, and then he put the silver shekels in, and then he covered it all up, and he stomped on it real good and put a rug over it so nobody could see. And he thought he really had himself a treasure. Well, the next battle that they were supposed to fight was the little battle of Ai. Now, Ai was not a great big walled city like Jericho had been, so Joshua thought, we don't even need to send all of the army this time. We'll just send part of the army, because we can win Ai in a snap. It'll be no problem at all. Well, they lost the battle of Ai, and there were fathers and sons and brothers that died and husbands. And the people came back and said, we lost the battle of Ai to that little tiny town. Now we're ruined. All of the people will no longer be afraid of us in Canaan. And Joshua didn't understand it either. And so he got down on his knees and he said, God, what's the deal here? My goodness gracious, you won the battle of Jericho and everybody was afraid of us. And now we've lost this little dinky town of Ai. And God said, Joshua, be still. There's sin in the camp. And Joshua said, well, tell me what the sin is, and I'll take care of it, God. And God said, I'll tell you what I want you to do. I want you to line up all the Israelites. I want them to line up according to their tribes. That's Asher and Dan and Issachar and Judah. And that's thousands of people that would line up in each of the 12 tribes. And I want them to march by in tribes, and I'll pick out the tribe where the sin is. Well, that's what they did. And one tribe went by, and another tribe went by. And finally, the tribe that Achan was in went by, and God said, whoop, that's the tribe. Joshua said, okay, what do I do now? Well, tell them to divide up in big family groups. I want mama and daddy and the aunts and the uncles and the cousins to all be in a group. And so Joshua told them to line up in groups. Now, Achan's beginning to feel a little bit strange. He's wondering about this. So he gets his mom and dad and his kids and his wife and his brothers and sisters and his cousins and all of his family group, and he goes back to the very back of the line. Well, one by one they pass by. And when the back of the line comes, God says, whoop, that's the group. Joshua says, okay, now what, small family groups? And God said, that's right. Just mama and daddy and the kids. Well, Achan took his group all the way to the back again, and he's beginning to have butterflies in his stomach, and his knees are beginning to play home sweet home in a minor key, and he's got perspiration on his forehead. He's beginning to worry. Well, God pointed out Achan's family, and Joshua said, Achan, what have you done? And Achan said, oh, goodness, I really didn't think it would matter much. What have you done, Achan? Well, back in my tent, way back in the back underneath the rug, there's a hole. And I put some stuff there that I took out of Jericho. God told us not to take anything out of Jericho. I know. I'm sorry. It's not much. And Joshua said to some soldiers, go find it. Well, they went, and on the way they thought, what terrific stuff do you suppose Achan took out of Jericho that would make God so mad that we lose the battle of Ai? Well, when they got there, they went back into the tent, and sure enough, they found the rug, and they picked it up, and they said, you can tell he's been digging, and they began to dig, and they found the purple robe, and they shook the dirt off of it, and they said, what do you want this for? It's got moth holes in it, and it's tarnished down the front where the gold is, and they put that aside, and they dug some more, and they found the gold wedge, and they said, well, that's not bad. You know, he could buy a lot of stuff with the gold wedge, and they kept looking, and pretty soon they found the shekels of silver. And they brought those things back to Joshua and set them down in front of him and said, this is what Achan took out of Jericho. And Joshua looked at that and he said, Achan, you took this junk out of Jericho? And Achan said, well, somehow it didn't look like junk when I took it out. And Joshua said, God, what are we to do with Achan? And he said, stone him to death and pile the stones up on he and his family, because mothers have lost their sons. Fathers have lost their brothers. Women have lost their husbands. You've lost the battle of Ai, and so leave those stones piled up to warn the Israelites that they'd better do exactly what I tell them to do from now on. And that's what happened to Achan. You see, Achan didn't think anybody saw him, but Achan was mistaken. Now, kids, sometimes your parents and the teachers tell you there are things they don't want you to do, and you think it's, well, it's not going to make all that much difference, and you do it anyway. Listen, if you disobey, you're mistaken. There's always a reason why mom and dad say no. There's always a reason why the teacher says, sit up straight and listen to me. I have something important to tell you. And if you see something and you think it isn't going to hurt if I steal that little boy's Hot Wheel or I walk off with that little girl's doll, she'll never miss it. Hey, you just remember that Achan didn't think anybody saw him either, but Achan was mistaken, and you're mistaken too.